path leads to the cut. The Banuke have nothing to offer besides useless mysticism. The Eclipse won't stand idle while you waste time playing in the snow. Return to your desk.
Surprised you're still checking up on me. I thought you had moved on.
Well, forgive me for still being concerned with the fate of the world.
I was thinking, Banuke shamans thread blue cables through their skin, right? Kind of like someone else we know, huh? So maybe the real reason you want me to stay clear of the Banuke is to stay clear of your past.
It's not the past that concerns me, Eloy. It's the future, or possible lack thereof. Which is why you should stop prattling and get back to what matters. But as usual, you'll do as you wish.
Touchy. Predator. Can see the heat coming off it. Got their attention.
Thank you.
I'd have to ditch something. It's a welcome, I guess.
You sure you'll be warm enough up here, Nora?
I've worked up a sweat from the climb.
We made it to the cut, Outlander.
Not that you'll stay long.
This is Song's Edge, biggest settlement in the cut.
These are dangerous lands, Outlander. Deadly even.
Smoke rising from the mountain. And the village, too. What's it for?
How are we to trust? There's so many died.
Thank you. long will Araya stay in retreat, out in the wilds?
Must be something big going on. Most of the village is moving towards that smoke.
The smoke from the mountain is worse today. Bad omen for the ritual.
Get ready for a rare sight, Nora. Burgrind, purveyor of necessities. Most of the time, the Banuk burn their dead. But not today.
Because the bodies couldn't be recovered.
Aye. A nasty business. All their best warriors. Lost. So they're getting a different kind of send-off.
Grasp your grief, my hunters, and kill it! For our kin sees the fate all Banuk long for. Falling with their spears striking steel. Their struggle is over now. You have witnessed their spirits rise up into the blue sky and beyond to the blue light. But our struggle is only beginning. Soon, we will again take up the hunt against the daemon that frenzies the machines against us! And so I ask you, can you summon the courage of our fallen kin? Will you fight and die as well as they did?
My courage! My spear!
Blood is in your teeth, Aratak!
We are Banuk. Our enemies are prey.
The daemon. That frenzies the machines.
Machines that wiped out their best. And what do they want to do? Go back up there. Fools. A little advice, for free.
Aloy.
I've been up here for two long winters, and I still can't make sense of the Banuk. Take this ruckus. It started with one of their shamans, Araya, spouting on about spirits and daemons up on Thunder's Drum. So they march their Warwick up there, and half of them get slaughtered by machines. When Araya vanished, I thought the crazy might have gone with her. But no. Here's Big Aratak, gearing them up to do it all over again.
What is it about the Banuk you can't make sense of?
Well, everything's a test to them. A hardship to endure. A challenge to survive.
Seems like they don't have much of a choice in a place like this.
Yeah. A land cold enough to crack teeth, filled with wild animals. You'd think they'd accept a little reasonably priced aid. Well, believe me, I've tried to convince them. But a Banuk with nothing left to prove might just lie down and die.
And Aurea is the one who spoke about this daemon?
That's right. Told Aratak and the others that it lives up on Thunder's Drum. And they believed him.
But you don't.
Look, I don't know what Aurea found up there. A shaman's not going to talk to an outlander. The machines in the cut are getting more vicious, that's a fact. It could be because of the daemon. Or it could be because they all got indigestion, for all I know. But Aurea's not around to explain. She took off, and no one knows why.
Is Aratak a renowned warrior around here?
He's a Warwick chieftain. His voice carries a lot of respect. Not that you hear much of it. Man talks about as much as a dead fish. But when he and Aurea came to town with their Warwick, it drew more Banuk to this little burg than I'd ever seen. Know what else I saw, Aloy? My own little trade route, stretching all the way back to the claim. Then, he goes and leads them off to their death at the claws of angry machines. So much for my best customers.
What are these Warwicks about, Bergrind? Some sort of tribe within the tribe?
Yeah, not like our clans back home. You don't get born into these things. They hold tryouts. Prove your best at something and you might get a place. Some Warwicks come and go. Some last as long as metal. The whole Banuk territory, Banur, is just a bunch of the biggest, oldest Warwicks.
I'm not sure if I'm less confused or more confused.
Well, here's the sure thing. Each Warwick has a chieftain and a shaman. They make the decisions. All well and good, except the chieftains are hard-headed, and the shamans have their heads in the clouds.
Have you ever heard of a man named Silence? Tall, deadly serious, cables in his skin, like a shaman?
I've heard that name once or twice, but always whispered, like some boogeyman the Banuk want to forget. I'm not sure what went down, but I got the impression he messed with the Conclave, or they messed with him.
Conclave?
All the most important shamans gather in Banur from time to time to keep up with the latest mumbo-jumbo. No idea how they all fit into one tent without those crazy headdresses getting locked up on each other. Aurea's been to that shindig, but when I asked her what it's like, she just gave me a dirty look. So if you want to know more, you'll have to find her and make her like you, I guess. Good luck.
You said you've lived out here for 2 winters?
Aye. Back home, some fur traders told me about this steel-forsaken heap of tents. Good location. Ripe for change. We were barely scraping by until this place started filling up for Aurea. A great prophet is coming, they said. Oh, I heard prophet. Honest mistake. Not that the Banuk are stingy, they just prefer to keep trade among themselves. We could get through to enough of them. We could really put this place on the map. Or at least on a map.
We?
Me and my daughter. My assistant, Varja. My assistant and my daughter. We seem to get along better as business partners. Her mother wanted me to show her a trade. She started tinkering with weapons. Say, when you need a break from this Banuk carry-on, stop in and see her. You're both, how do I put it?
Women?
No. Independent. Look for her at Long Notch, the easternmost Banuk camp.
I want to know more about this daemon.
It's crazy talk, Aloy.
Or there's something to it. Something connected to how the machines behave.
Then you need to find Aurea. She was last seen headed for the mountains they call the Ice Rests. I've heard only the shamans know the trail beyond those frozen peaks. But I do know where you could find her apprentice, Naltuk. He went north of the river, chasing rumors.
Rumors?
Not the good kind. Sudden attacks in the snow. Strange new structures. Some say a new machine, like no one's seen before.
Well, now I'm definitely interested. Thanks for the talk, Reverend.
Don't mention it.
I wonder if our talk could tell me more about Araya, Thunderstorm. Maybe worth a shot?
Tallneck and the Frostfigures.
Damon's new machine. Come on.
No more music.
I mourn the machines who've been enslaved by the Damon. The best gift we can give them is a...
You seem sad, stranger. I heard you mention a flood?
Yes. A sudden deluge, without rain or melt to explain it. I'm Laulai, the drummer of Deep Din. Or at least I was, until it disappeared under the waters.
Deep Din. What's that?
A hollow, carved out by the old ones. A chamber, a basin, and a musical instrument all at once. My life, my calling. I'd explain it by playing for you if I could. But its pipes are deep under the water now.
So Deep Din is a place, and a musical instrument?
Yes. Pipes that carry a perfect tone beneath a sonorous basin. A wondrous edifice the old ones used to carry music far and wide. During the war, my father played the pipes to rally the Banuk against the Karja. I'm the drummer now. But our battles are few and far between. Mostly I play for the joy of it. Or to remember my family. Of course, if the waters don't recede, what's the point of joy? Or remembering?
So the waters came fast.
One day it was dry. The next, the nearby river had risen and the entire basin was flooded. I don't understand it. There was no rain, not even any clouds, and yet the river rose higher than I'd ever seen it. And there it remains.
A flood without rain. That is strange. Where is this place? I'll have a look if I'm in the area.
Just northwest of here. Look all you like, but I don't see what good it'll do. The floodwaters aren't going anywhere. How does one ask a river to relent?
How long until the demon goes to the ship?
Water lapping on old stone. That's the sound to sleep to,
shall
not
we all?
To.
The older hunters speak of a time before the machines grew so aggressive. How did it yours?
Welcome to the cut, stranger.
Okay. I want to learn more about how this daemon affects the machines. I've got to find Araya. And to do that, I need to talk to her apprentice, who followed the river north.
Outlander, wait.
None of the
southern
tribes rival the Banuk as hunters. But some are skilled.
Any news from the hunt?
The herd isn't roaming far from the camp.
Keep it together this time.
Then.
Everything's freezing. Ground, the air, me.
Now stands as Sunhawk of the Hunter's Lodge.
So?
She played by the rules and won.
Bergen said Araya's apprentice went north of the river. Hopefully not too far. Maybe I could override it. Thank you. This'll do nicely. Oh. Follow the river, find its source. Seems simple enough. Must be the entrance to this den. Shake it out later. There. That must be where the water's coming from. Looks like something the old ones built. somebody wanted in. Nearly blew this entire ledge off just to get through the door.
Flooding detected. Evacuation recommended. Overflow basin compromised.
The overflow basin. Wait, is that the dip? Looks like a control center. What happened in here to start the water flowing? Another holographic interface. There must be some kind of code. Maybe I should try scanning objects in this area. And there's our troublemaker. Doesn't seem to be as good at getting out as he is at getting in. That Oseram must have forced his way through here. Are you all right?
You don't know how happy you just made me. For a moment, I thought my fire was snuffed.
My forge gone cold.
But nope, nope. Not old Gildan.
You're welcome. Wait. Start from the beginning. What are you doing down here?
Ow! My apologies. When you mostly talk to yourself, you can tell your stories in whatever order you like. There's an artifact in that storage room I simply must acquire. But as you may have noticed, the door won't budge. I took one of those roundish, ringy what's-its from the wall beside the door. No luck. So I had to go at that panel with the button. Even less luck. My gentle experimentation caused the chamber to flood. So I pushed the button again, perhaps a little too enthusiastically. Sparks and smoke. Now, obviously, I came here to investigate. My cautious footsteps may have contributed slightly to the collapse of a bridge. When the bridge began to collapse, I may have, for the sake of expedience, abandoned the cumbersome ringy what's-it to the waves. By the time I thought to give up the endeavor, the door had closed behind me. And thusly do we come to the present moment.
You said something about an artifact?
Indeed. That storage room is brimming with treasures from the old ones. But one in particular caught my eye. An intricate looking glass. I've only seen one such device before. My old mum brought one back for me from wherever she'd gone to that time. I remember holding it, staring into its face, seeing myself and my mother just over my shoulder, smiling.
And one of these looking glasses, it's in the storage room.
Oh, yes. I'm quite sure. I peered into that dim little chamber, and there it was. I've wanted to find one for so long, I... Yes, this time I'm sure I have.
Well, there's no way we're getting into that storage room without another ring. It's part of the locking mechanism that controls the door.
You don't say. Well, that's fantastic news. Marvelous, even. You've got two hands. I've got two hands. Perfect! My savior, my salvation, and if you like, why wouldn't you? Of course you will. My accomplice. Together, that ring is as good as ours, and with it, the storage room and its spoils.
Didn't you say you dropped the ring in the water?
Well, I'll grant you that adds a heretofore undiscussed level of complexity to the proceedings.
So you found the button that controls the flow of water.
Quite by accident.
And then you broke that button.
Also, quite by accident.
The panel's the only way to shut this place down, as far as I can tell. This isn't gonna be easy.
That storage room is filled, top to bottom. Would you be surprised to find the parts you need in there? I certainly wouldn't be.
So, we need to replace that ring and get into the storage room. Then I can fix the panel and shut this place down.
And I can finally wrap my fingers around that looking glass.
Okay, Gildan. How are we gonna get that ring?
Two sets of hands, girl! Two sets of hands! Behind us lie a pair of enormous gates, but I believe the gates must be operated in tandem. Together, we can dry this place out.
Guess we better get started then.
I guess we better. Up ahead, girl. See the valve? Time to put our hands to use. I'll take care of this one. There's another valve on the other side to lock the gate in place. Would you mind heading across and doing the honors? You know, I thought I saw some kind of tunnel up there. Might provide a means to cross the gap. Any luck finding that tunnel, girl?
You know, I'm reminded of a delve I undertook out near the plant. Stone ruins, wild falls, lake fire. I've been 13 levels on that contract,
and there's
no
wall. Above stagnant water. Charming.
You made it! Now grab that valve and give it a spin.
On it.
A little more now, and I should be able to get the blasted gate moving.
There. You should be able to lower the gate.
Huh? Right you are! Now, when I get this gate down, you'll need to turn the valve again. On a... lock this thing in place.
One gate down.
Halfway through then, aren't we? To the second gate! A ladder is a rare and special thing, girl. Can depend on it to take you exactly where you need to go, and no further. I'd wager the valves for the second sluice gate are somewhere above us. How are we gonna get up there?
Let me look around, see what I can find. Looks like I could jump across on that rickety resting platform. I'll find a way up.
Thank you.
strong. You can't swim against it. It's even less refreshing than it looks.
Forge, girl! Careful! Don't want you drowning in this ruin now, do we? Oh, you're close, girl! Just spring across the gap! Ah! You're right above me! Just send that ladder on down!
Look out below!
Now we've done this once before. Should be as easy as falling down a hole. If you'd take the valve on the other side.
It's set up the same way on this side. I should look for an access tunnel.
This is my sort of dell. Found a little problem. A million miles in a typical fashion.
Gildan. Okay, Gildan, turn the valve.
It's not working! Damn thing's too heavy. Behind me, would you? See anything big and, broken?
Looks like part of the counterweight broke off. If I can get up there, my weight might be enough to get it moving again.
Hang on, okay? I've got a plan.
I need to get up higher. Could climb up that wreckage. That's pretty much what I do. Easier when I was a kid. Jump straight to the counterweight from here. And I could climb higher, but wait.
Good to go!
You were a sight to see! Bounding from metal rust trap to metal rust trap. Still a bit of water, but low enough, wouldn't you say? Now, where's that wreck?
Good question.
Well, at least I should be able to swim now.
Snap maw! It's a snap maw! Very, very big snap maw!
I see it, Gildan!
Very big, very, very big!
Just stay out of the way!
Thank you.
It's dead.
Marvelous. So, the ring. Maybe if you pry its jaws open and reach inside, I can't look.
You were right. This thing did swallow the ring.
Ha! That's the old Gildan intuition in action. It's never led me astray. Sure, its chosen routes can be a bit circuitous, but never mind. To the storage room. To the spoils. More old world treasures, perhaps? This place is full of surprises. Should we have a look?
Didn't you want to get... We drained enough water for what we need to do, but... I wonder if I could empty out the whole dam. Pipes, valves. Maybe I can drain the rest of the water from here. Sure are a lot of valves. Should check my focus first. Could be something around that my focus will see. All right, time to get the flow going to the right place.
I say this as a man typically enamored of complexities, but this looks like it might be a little much for me.
Don't worry, I think I've got this.
Music to my ears. To each job its proper tool. Toothpicks make horrible arrows, as the saying goes.
That didn't help. The water can't pass through. I need to get the water through the pipes. That's not about right.
You got a competent mind, girl. A mind for nuance and finesse. Not I. No, indeed. Not old Gildan.
Demands a certain degree of patience, doesn't it?
I'm afraid I inherited my mother's restlessness.
Track.
You've been at this a while, girl. No room to judge, mind. I once spent half a day flummoxed by a Karja puzzle box.
There. One step closer.
Mm-hmm.
Something's not right. There. One step closer. The water's flowing, just not where it needs to. There, that should do it. I should head back. See if that's okay for us.
Got it working, did you? Of course you did! Never met a conundrum you couldn't unconundrum, have you?
The door's open. Guess it's sealed because of the flag. This must go down to the lower level. Stinks down here. Looks like that's everything.
You smell that?
I should head back up with Gildan.
Smells like a forge side morning in the claim.
See? Check this out! We could just bang on this pipe, you know? Could we sample that or? Oh, totally! Like, what about after the. Oh, sorry.
I can't wait! Almost there! Soon I'll hold the looking glass in my hand. Just like Mom and I used to.
The lock positions. Helpful.
What are you doing with your hands there, girl? I can't believe that worked. I thought you'd lost your mind tickling the empty air like that.
I mean, this is it.
Where is it?
Get to play together, what?
Where did it go?
Maybe two more times? Farewell tour! Reunion tour in like 6 months.
Gildan? Everything okay?
I was so sure I saw it. The looking glass. I was so sure. Right there in the window. I would... Of course. Trick of the light. Nothing at all.
I'm sorry, Gildan. It must have meant a lot to you.
Oh, well. Much as any artifact of the old ones would mean to me, really. It's fine. I'm fine. Besides,
What are the spoils compared to the Delve? That's why we do it, girl. The Delve, not the treasure. And what a Delve it was! By the great Blazing Forge, I'll never forget that. Now then, I believe we have some repairs to make. It's a whole lot prettier, isn't it? What does it mean?
It means it worked.
By the forge! Ah, you are a wonder! Do you hear that often? I'll hazard a guess you do.
I've heard something like that once or twice.
Oh, she's modest now. A master of the arts of the old ones, a delver to shame the entire claim, and she wants to be modest.
It's not like I did it alone, Gildan.
No. No, I suppose not.
So what's next for you? On your way back to the claim?
And deprive the people of Song's Edge the story of this encounter? Perish the thought! I'll stay there a while longer. But a story is best told by all who encountered it. Come and lend a hand, won't you?
Overflow basin empty. Interior accessible. Minimal flood damage.
Sounds like the basin is dried out too. Maybe I'll take a look.
Another adventure so soon? Woo! You're braver than me. But there was no question of that.
Water's lower. And going by that sound, I think Lao Lai's already at the dune. kidding about the sound. Happy to be playing again.
I don't know what you did, but the water drained in the snap of a short song. What do you think of the music?
I've never heard anything else like it.
That's because there's no other place with such resonance, such intonation that rattles your ribs with its power. And of course, no one else knows these pipes like I do. I learned them by ear before I could walk, strapped to my father's back. Thank you for draining the waters. Not just for myself, but for my ancestors and their songs. Please, take this as a token of our gratitude.
To see a fresh face in these lands. We see precious few.
Knock one of those over. I'm about to last. Scavengers have just gotten started. should scan the Tallneck. See how deep the damage goes. Anything my focus could reveal. Feels like sunburn. You're alert. Easy, easy. handy. Save this for later. part still in one piece. Well, that fits. Sure hope it works. Well, it's in better shape than it was. Blink, my eyes will freeze shut. Okay, I'm right. I just need to get the power flowing through it. And if I'm wrong, at least no one's watching. Wake you up? Easy now. Easy! Right, it's never easy. Ha! This should be a good spot for jumping onto the Tallneck.
Made it. Now to climb up to its head.